नमस्कार डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम अमनदीप फ्रॉम क्रिएटिव डिज़ाइन कंसल्टेंट्स एंड इंजीनियर्स प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। वी आर स्ट्रक्चरल डिज़ाइन एंड प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट प्रोफेशनल्स। इन दिस टुडेज प्रेजेंटेशन आई वुड बी टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ कंस्ट्रक्शन सेक्टर कैन हेल्प इन डिजास्टर मिटिगेशन एंड कैन कंट्रीब्यूट फॉर द ग्रोथ ऑफ द नेशन। वी ऑल नो दैट the construction sector plays a very important role in our GDP, the contribution being more than rupees 2.5 lakh crore. Now it is not a small amount. Now how we can use or utilize this construction industry spendings in a manner that the industry grows as well as the nation grows in a faster way. I would like to talk about three key aspects. The first aspect is skill development. The second aspect is your technological development. And the third aspect is the regulation. Now, if we are able to impart proper training to the construction professionals and can utilize the technological research into the construction industry, then we can make wonders. And besides that, the regulation is also important. So I will be taking 10 minutes on these aspects. Now I am coming to the training aspect first, because when we talk about training, generally we focus on the artisans, masons or the construction workers. Of course, the training for these workmen is important, because ultimately the deliverables are coming through their hands. But dear friends, it is not only the artisan or masons who are constructing. It is the engineer's role, like what should be the construction material, how and what kind of system we are going to use. All these things should be translated through a construction professional. So if the construction professional is not properly trained or educated, or when I say educated, it doesn't mean only the degree, because a college or the institution can give the basic platform, but that is not enough. The basic platform should be further skilled to make them a real professional. So how we can train the mid-level construction professionals who are actually the execution engineers at site? So first focus should be for the development of the construction engineers, because generally what is my personal finding is the engineers who are coming out of the colleges and reaching to the construction site, generally they are not following the further education. They are not taking any further training to educate or to skill themselves. They are just doing whatever is being told them to do. So that is not enough. So first of all, they should be having their education, or I would say a special skill training in which they can develop themselves to give faster deliverables, safe deliverables and durable deliverables. Now here I would like to focus on durability more, because other things, generally basic trainings are being important, but the durability is the factor which is going to help the country. Because if the design life or the execution life of a structure is increased, say by 10 years, say if originally is for the current scenario 30-40 years is the life which is trouble free, and if we are able to make it 50 to 60 years, then automatically we are saving 30 to 40% of the cost of that facility construction. So that is a huge saving, and it is just coming through the correct workmanship and good selection and skillful work. No extra cost. Simply, if I talk about concrete as a construction material, if the concrete is not made properly, even if you have spent more if you have consumed more cement, even then you may not get good life of the structure. So the concrete making skill should be developed in a manner that we are getting durable execution. Now sometimes we have different environmental conditions and we have to select a particular type of cement for that environment. Now for that the skill should be there. These kind of knowledge generally we have in institutions, the design level offices, but sometimes we require these kind of skills at the execution site also. So because from there only the actual execution is translating into the facility. So that focus, I would like to emphasize that just like this is an example that concrete making only, but for if you are using structural steel, then proper welding and proper handling, painting and so many things. So if we are able to educate the execution level team, we can get huge benefits in durability and quality. Now second aspect is technology. I find that quite a good research is being taking place in different research institutions, whether these are IITs, NITs or other many excellent research institutions are working in this direction to get very suitable construction industry requirement related research. But that research is not reaching to the actual execution. This is another aspect that we should try to develop the system in which the research of the institutions should be translated to the actual execution. Now construction industry professionals or the bigger groups, industries can participate, can handhold the technological institutions for the research to take it to the ground reality. So this is another suggestion how we should be able to take this actual research findings to the actual ground reality. So if we are able to club these two aspects, one is the research being taken to the design level office or the execution level office, and from that to the actual construction execution team to the ultimately the reality of the construction facility. So that makes the system as a whole as a complete channel and is going to help the construction industry as a whole. Now coming to the regulation. In our construction industry, at this moment, what we see is that only the qualification is giving the authority to take decision and making the final commitments for the project. Whereas there is sometimes lacking the commitment. So we should have a complete system in which whether these are decision makers or execution teams or the construction workers, all equally responsible for their work, and accountability should be fixed for all the construction professionals. So there should be, it is just a suggestion, though I do not have anything ready-made which I can suggest, but there is a need of a mechanism which can regulate the complete construction industry, because only then we will get the fruits of technology, research, skilled engineering team, and the actually good execution by the workmen. So this is the message I wanted to convey through this forum. For any point of view from my side, you can always communicate with me. One can mail to me at aman.str@gmail.com. Thank you.